Good morning, everybody, and welcome to .dj Productions. And as you can probably see, we have the S and S, let me just try working my mouth quickly. Southington and Chatham Railway, Harry Rainwhite, H-Class, 044 Tank Engine. So we are going to be doing a Dark Rise on this. It's sort of early access because this is before it comes out to the public. So hopefully this will encourage people to give it a go. So, yeah, let's see what we've got. But first of all, let me introduce my co-pilots for the morning. And I just literally heard Callum in my voice thing.
Oh.
Hello. Yeah, I kind of had a little boo-boo when I was trying to start it up.
Yeah, I noticed that.
So now I've had to go again. So anyway, I'm going to quickly explain something pretty cool. So I'm unpausing the game, which is... because I'm going to go through deliveries and stuff, but first and foremost, I'd like to say I'm on the DR, and this class of loco is actually incredibly appropriate because the railway lines around Horton, Colhapper, Gallen Junction, Maxis Heath, blah, 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 that was all ex-Southeastern and Chatham Railway, more specifically, Southeastern Railway. So, having one of these running about is going to be quite appropriate in this video. Mm.
Indeed.
So, first impressions, obviously, you know, love it, basically. Haven't really got much else to say, just love it, love it, love it. It's lovely! So, yeah, it's a tank engine. So we're going to go through deliveries first, and I'll do a bit more about its history. Designed by, I can't pronounce his name properly, it's going to sound come out stupid, Harry Wainwright.
That's it. Well done.
I managed to make my mouth work this time. He designed these, I think they were modifications, like, you know, modified design of one of his older, earlier designs. Either him or Matthew Kirtley, I can't remember. But Matthew Kirtley, I think, was London, Chatham, Dover Railway. And Rainwright was Southeastern Railway. When they were amalgamated, it was Rainwright rather than Kirtley. I don't know. Can't remember too much about it. But anyway, we're going to start off with what is technically not the earliest, but it's going to be the earliest for the sake of this video because I've got a train waiting in the, you know, the screenshot we've got for the video. That is waiting down at Colhapper West. So we'll start off with this one, which is number 546 in grey. Wartime grey. It looked
great.
It looked grey. So yeah, we have that. Oh god, my camera work is shoddy. I'm really sorry, everyone. I love the design of the cabs anyway, the way they sort of like dip in. You can probably see from the back view in a minute. Like the way the cab dips in at the top. That's a very nice stylistic choice. So yeah, you've got wartime grey. Obviously, you've got Southern Olive, which is, again, splendid. I mean, that's the livery. That's one of my favourite liveries ever anyway, obviously, because I'm a Southerner.
Yeah, it looks gorgeous.
And then we've got Bully Sunshine, Southern Black, so that's Second World War. So basically, you've got First and Second World War liveries there, which is nice. And then you've got Early British Railways here. So, like, literally as it went into British Railways. And then you've got the three BR liveries here, which include BR Lakecrest, obviously. British Railways, Gill Sands, which is, like, 1948-49. And then Early Crest there, which is, like, you know, 1950 to 1956. Again, I mean, I would show you it, but I'm already in-game. But this has also got Locomotion 1.2 from Sim Nation on it. And, it just makes editing numbers and stuff so much easier because it's easier to understand for people. So yeah, you know, thumbs up. Also, I must admit, I'm being very much drawn to the BR Black livery, which is really annoying because it does look it suits it very well.
BR Black is bay on anything. Changed my mind.
What about this? British Railways. What about the bullied one? I'm not a fan of that one, actually. Of all the liveries, I think that one's my least favourite. That's not saying much because I love all the liveries. So
yeah, I mean, it's the least favourite out of the ones you love.
Yeah, there's 8 variants in total. You might notice there's only 7 here at Colhapper. That's because we are going to go down to Colhapper West. And we're going to pick up the preserved example in real life. SECR number 263. With some coaches.
That looks beautiful. Holy shit.
So, in that case, let's have a look in the cab then. Ooh, it's a cab.
Is it?
It's his.
Wow.
If I remember correctly, it's not Chris who modelled this, is it? Or did he model it? I can't remember.
I don't remember.
I don't think he modeled it.
I can tell it's not Chris's modeling because you can't open the doors. Unless Chris did model it, in which case, I think DT gave it to Chris to texture. So that's my fault. Yeah.
Well, basically, DT gave it to Chris to finish off, and they gave him virtually nothing to work with.
I mean, Ferris.
Yeah.
I think that was the main gist of it.
However, it is nice to have... Oh, he did put his bloody camera on it this time. Chris has put his Chris Wilson camera is on this one.
Hey!
Hey!
I think that's just simulation, though. Oh, simulation.
Oh, it might be. Oh, the fire! Look at the fire! Ooh! Fire
Come on,
good.
Baby, let my fire.
Actually, that fire looked pretty convincing from this angle.
Yeah, because they've made like realistic fireboxes now.
Nice, love it. So yeah, that's the cab. It's kind of nice actually to be able to drive. Can you open? Oh no, they haven't modelled that you can open the roof hatch. That reminds me, when Chris watches this, Big Bob needs a roof hatch, please. Thank you. But anyway, you're here to drive it and look at it, so let's do that and talk about thingies. So we're going to go up the line, talk about things, and then we're going to finish up wherever. I don't know where. We'll probably just go as long as we can, I guess.
I think to a station.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
No, just stop between two stations just to be a cunt to Callum.
Yeah, could do.
Oh.
Also, ladies and gentlemen, I will be firing today, so be warned.
Yeah, Callum, you're the guard.
Okay.
Right, so we are at Colhapple West, so we're letting people on.
You can't come on, you're not attractive enough. No, go over there with the rest of the plebs. No. Oh, hello, darling. You can come on my train.
I'm pretty sure that's not how it works. But anyway, I find it really nice that we've actually... Because, like, obviously, there isn't really... I don't think... In fact, apart from when Ben was making his R1, this is technically the first release of a Southeastern Chatham Railway locomotive, I think.
Yeah, and in fact, R1, that's also another Wainwright engine, so this is technically...
The second Wainwright, yeah.
But it's the first one to be publicly released.
Yeet. Mm. So, would we like to hear what the whistles sound like?
No.
Oh. Yes, I want to hear the whistles.
Fine, everyone shush. Nice and high pitched, I love it. Just seeing it have any old whistles, it doesn't. Okay, anyway, enough of that. Let's get going then. So we're on an appropriate route in an appropriate region. Not an appropriate time period though, because this is technically the future. But it makes sense because 263 is preserved in our timeline, so.
Shit, said Thomas.
Shit. So yeah, does it developed by Digital Traction in principle. Obviously Chris Wilson doing the texturing and stuff.
Yeah.
And SimNation's Locomotion 1.2 for scripting.
Yeah, I think that Chris had to do all of the animations as well, didn't he?
Oh, did he actually? Oh, okay.
I think so. Because I don't think DT could be bothered.
Fair dues.
So pretty much you're buying this for Chris Wilson's work. I think that's fair to say.
Yeah. It's got the, apparently it's got the E4 sounds on it. But that's mainly for the whistles and things. But I don't think it matters too much because... I mean, is the preserved one running, do we know?
I don't know, actually.
I'm not 100% if it is or not.
Let me do a little bit of Googling.
I'm sure it had a boiler overhaul recently. To be fair, the chuff sounds aren't that bad anyway, so it's very throaty.
The E4 does have a great chuff sound, and if this has the same, then
Yeah, it does.
It goes chomp.
Does it actually?
Yeah, it goes chomp.
Oh, it's also got the obligatory performance mode as well, so if I open the firebox doors, you see the smoke effect, so it can shift P, turns performance mode to low, and then press it again, turns it off. As in, it turns the particle effects off. So, I mean, that's good for people who have lower spec computers like you, Callum.
Yay!
Although we're hoping that you're going to get yours sorted out soon, aren't we?
Yes.
Hey, Gallo. get on my level because we want you to have a good computer because you deserve it.
No, you don't. Oh. Oh, doesn't it look quite? Also, I mean, doesn't it look quite appropriate? Like very much Southern Railway, you know, Southern 1950s. Well, the livery's wrong, but I do like that. It looks splendid.
Yeah. Also, I really like the headout view because you can see that gorgeous livery.
It is
a stunning livery.
If I remember correctly, Chris had to retexture the whole thing, didn't he?
Mm.
Because the original one was too light. In real life, this livery is like this, really dark. It's just certain lightings that make it look brighter, I think.
Yeah.
I must admit, well, I do like the way the cab is. Like, you know, in reality, well, the cab's like this. Like, I don't know if you can see, but like, well, you should be able to see the way that it sort of inward of the frames of the outside.
Yeah.
And then it goes up and curves back out again. I really like that. It's like having a little like canopy, I guess, when you're looking out the side of the engine. Good for forward visibility, actually.
Yeah. Because it's like, it's standard across Wainwright engines, because the R1 has exactly the same arrangement.
Oh, by the way, for people who are wondering, I managed to actually fix my signals.
Oh.
Basically, the way you fix it is you have to edit your signals in 32-bit. Because 64-bit, for some reason, corrupts your signals.
Well, that's your problem, isn't it?
Yeah, well, you know, I am a corrupt politician.
Oliver, is that you?
Oh, I hope not. We don't need any politics today. Oh, speaking of things, actually, I was going to say something to everyone. I mean, it's a bit of a Patreon thing. I know that we're sort of like doing the stream on the H-class, but we were talking about, weren't we, Chris, about, I mean, Callum might be interested to hear this, maybe adding a new thing to the Patreon campaign, like a $5 or more pledge.
We were?
Yeah, we're talking about the driver experience.
I know. I'm fucking.
Oh, okay. But anyway.
I've read that.
Yeah. Basically, the idea is, I mean, more specifically for when Big Bob is built, as in DR1202. His name isn't Big Bob, I'm just going to call it Big Bob because that's the class nickname. It is a Big Bob. It's like the, what are they called? Like the, you know, Dukes are called Dukes, aren't they? And, you know...
Duke Dogs are called Duke Dogs.
Yeah, exactly. But they're not named a Duke Dog, if that makes sense. So, the idea is that we would host, or I would host, a virtual driver's experience course with the patrons. So you'd need a few things, for example, like a decent internet connection, a fast one preferably. You would also need to be on the Discord chat, to be in the chat room with us, and you'd also need TeamViewer. And the idea would be is that one, like, you could either drive big, like, you know, the Big Bob class, or you could pick your own loco you wanted to drive from my catalog, and you could virtually drive up and down the dark railway with me as your, like, you know, supervisor, if you like. Like, you would, they would have the controls, like, they would be able to control it from their end and see it on my computer. That's why I'm saying you need the good internet speed, because me and Chris have done this before, and it works pretty well, doesn't it, Chris?
Oh, yeah, it does, as soon as I can get the sensitivity working.
Yeah, because every time, I mean, I'll show you what, every time Chris moved his mouse, it went like this. he'd move it, literally, Chris, you'd move it, like, half an inch, and go,
Yeah.
But anyway, I like the idea of doing that, because basically the idea was, I'm thinking the DR would have driver experience courses, and we'd shut the railway down, or start a sector of the railway down, in order to run those driver experiences. So what if patrons were to, because obviously this is to help with the Big Bob campaign anyway, but it's also something I'd find quite fun to record for you. Like, you know, if a patron wanted to, I could record them driving on the DR and put it up on my channel with them having a conversation with me. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm going to leave it to the comment section, as I usually do, but I don't know what people think about that idea. So
you should also post it in the group itself, in the page.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll write it down later on. So.
Yeah. Also, we have been invaded by Mr. Standard, too.
Oh, have we? Oh, no. Hello, Anthony. Right, I'm not going to take the... I'm not taking the mick out of... Thingy Bobs today, because we've got more important things to do, like drive this. So I don't know whether you caught what I just said there, Anthony, but what do you think of that idea? Obviously, we'd need to explain that they're not allowed to do anything else on my computer, and if they try it, I just literally, like, you know, shut down the computer and shut off TeamViewer. So you'd have to basically be trustworthy enough to do it.
Yeah, and if you do fuck up, you're never allowed to do it ever again. So, yeah, take it seriously, guys.
Mm-hmm. I might have just noticed something about the H class.
Yeah, I think I've noticed what you're noticing. It's leaning forward a bit, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
I mean, it's not as noticeable up like from close, but when you look from far away, in fact, if I turn the injector off, I'll mention it to Chris because he'll probably patch it, unless it's to do with the coupling. But when you look at it from the side, you can see, yeah, especially here when I put it to the platform.
It really drops down.
The locomotive dips down at the front. Oh, I'll mention it to Chris, even though I know it's not Chris's fault because he didn't model the whole loco. But obviously Chris is like basically my contact for DT, so you can see here, if you come down to the wheels, I know this is like me bug testing, but this is again why you ask people like me to bug test and beta test, because I spot these things. So hopefully Chris will notice that. I'll message Chris with it later. But
that might just be all that needs fixing. It just needs like
it might just be the center of gravity. Does not detract from the fact it's a beautiful locomotive and the textures look great and the simulation's great. It's just a little thing that probably slipped through. It might even be unique to this one locomotive, I don't know. I'll have to do some further testing after this. Why can't I still hear an injector?
Look pretty. Because you're a banana.
I can hear an injector sound, but there's no injectors on.
It might be because you've got your brakes in the release.
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Might just be another little thing, I don't know. But anyway, let's head up the line to Gander Junction then. So anyway, you guys' thoughts on the whole driver experience thing. Would you guys think that's a good idea for the Patreon campaign or what?
Yes.
I think it would be, especially when Big Bob's done.
Yeah.
Because people would be able to have the chance to actually
drive the locomotive that they're helping fund, yeah.
And let's not forget
Chungus.
James just pointed something out. Chris, yeah. Serious, like the time you tried to crash Dave. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, we're not doing that again, Chris.
The opportunity was there, and I had a chance, and Tom knew what I was doing, and he busted me.
Yeah, because at that point I was still smoking, and I had my phone downstairs. I was like, oh. What's this, Chris? Oh, whoa, what's this?
I was just waiting for, like, as soon as he pressed escape just before the turntable, I was like, wait, what the fuck? And I went to click escape, and he already quit the fucking scenario.
it was like this. Notice this, Chris. Oh, whoa, what's this?
Another thing I've noticed, just again, I'm sorry to sound like I'm nitpicking, because I'm not trying to. It's just things I'm noticing. I don't think the wheel is centered ever so slightly correctly. If you look in this view, you'll see that it's ever so slightly bobbing.
It is a beta test, remember?
Yeah, but that's what I mean. Hopefully this is stuff that DT, once I feed back to them, they'll be able to say, oh. Because again, I'm not detracting from the model at all.
No.
These are just slight niggles.
Yeah, all you need to do is just go over to DT and say, excuse me!
What, leave me like I usually do, like, give me!
Yeah.
Give me!
The important thing to note is, like we've said, this is the beta, because the thing isn't available yet.
Yeah, so this might even be an opportunity for someone outside of DT to say, hey dudes, there's a little tiny baby problem that you might need to sort out.
But,
other than that, I mean, I like it, as usual.
Yeah, no. From what I've seen, seeing as I can't drive it, Chris! No, I'm kidding.
Chris! Oh, went James right.
Right. No, but I'm going to get this as soon as it comes out, because this thing looks beautiful.
The livery is gorgeous.
I know. I mean, that's why I specifically chose the livery, because this is like, you know, what you'd say is a signature livery for this loco, because it's how it's preserved. This is how this engine preserved.
Is also how the green's the green. Oh man.
Oh, super elevation.
I know, right?
Like when you were down that view on the wheels, can you go back to it?
Yeah, hold on one sec. I'm just gonna do a pan shot of the locos that come past this bit, and then I'll go back to the wheels. Well, I got something else to point out, Mr. Anthony.
It's not a criticism, but I say.
Yeah, we'll have a look. We'll have a look. I mean, you could criticize my route. I've just noticed some floating fences. How absurd. How
Tom,
annoying.
God damn it, you need to fix that shit.
I know, I need to fix this shit right away.
The track's floating too.
I know! Horrible.
Oh my god, Tom, I'm so troggered right now.
I'm literally troggered about my own route at the moment. Anyway, so you want to see the back that view again, Anthony? Hold on. Here we go. What are we looking at? It'll be there in a sec. Don't worry. I have noted, though, that the injector sound does not turn off once you've turned it on.
Yeah, that's it. I can see it's kind of rocking. The engine's kind of... You see the logo kind of rocking in this shot.
Oh, yeah! Well, I can see it well now. I don't know whether that's the track elevate... the track bumpiness, though, Anthony.
I think what it is that because it's...
off-centre a cab, bit. Oh, yeah, of course it's a cab view, isn't it?
Yeah, so a cab view, it would rock a bit more. I've noticed that with the Caledonian stuff.
Oh, my God. Hang on. Oh, God, that was a big lag spike again.
Jeez.
That is it trying to load everything at Gallon Junction, that's why.
It's trying to load gallons and gallons of junction.
I mean, if I come out into this view, and then I'm going to zoom the camera in and have a look. Again, we're not really... like I hate to use the word criticising, but we're sort of just noticing things.
Yeah. And if that's how it's supposed to be, like, if the leaning forward is how it's supposed to be, then, well, shit, we're wrong, and let it be like that.
I mean, I'm looking now, Anthony, I'm not seeing that rock as much now.
Well, you do have bumpy track, remember?
Yeah, that's what I mean, I'm not seeing the rocking that Anthony was talking about.
I can't see it that much.
Yeah. It's bumping just a little bit, but then again...
Yeah, but it's not that track. Bad. I mean, overall, we need more 044 tanks anyway, because the only one we've really got is the, what, M7?
Yeah. G5.
Oh, yeah, we've got the G5 as well. And I think Chris is now working on what? A Q-class, I think. And London Chatham. Is that London Chatham Dover Railway Q-class? Or is it an SECR Q-class? Can't remember which definition it is.
Let me just Google it.
No idea. Real quick, though.
Hello.
That's someone said. Jack Allos Smith. Alwood, not Allo. This thing is coming out when Chris releases it. We don't know yet. He hasn't told us, but it should be out.
It'll be out soon. I'm assuming within the next couple of days, like maybe even tonight. I don't know.
Yeah, we never know with Chris. Sometimes he'll say it's next week, then it'll release tomorrow, and sometimes.
Yeah, but it's not. Remember though, it's not all down to Chris. It's DT.
No, that's true.
This is a DT product, so it's DT who decides when it gets released.
That's true.
And this is basically me wanting to show. I mean, like, because obviously. I mean, I can also, I mean, you know what? I can definitely tell it's DT. Do you know why?
Why?
I don't see any inside valve gear. Chris would not neglect inside valve gear. Like animated inside valve gear. That's how I know that it's not a Chris Wilson product in total. That is not a problem. That is just me saying I know that what this product is. It's digital traction.
Just to make sure.
Yeah.
Are we stopping at Gallon Junction?
Yeah, why?
We'll have a look inside them, won't we?
What, inside the frames?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have a look there.
Yeah.
Have you already shown off the variants?
I've shown them off back at Kolhapa.
You joined late, bitch.
Yeah, Anthony, you pleb.
Well, tough.
I'm tempted to go somewhere and then go back anyway to show off the variants once again before we finish. I might go as far as Axley, maybe?
Yeah. Well, I'm just doing a little bit of I've just done a little bit of googling.
You better not. You better not have, young man.
Well, I'm sorry, Tom.
Oh
but,
no.
Yeah. I've looked at the South Eastern Railway and there was a Q-class 044 designed by James Stirling's son.
Oh my god.
And Greeny. Then the locomotives were passed into SECR ownership.
What the hell?
In 1899, and 55 of them were rebuilt by Mr. Harry Wayne. Damn it! Harry
Wayne. It's really
Wainwright.
Hard. It's hard to say, isn't it?
Yeah, because you go
I say Howie Wainwright.
Harry Wainwright.
Wowie Wainwright.
Yeah, they were rebuilt by Harry Wainwright to Class Q1 between 1903 and 1919.
That's just cheeky, isn't it?
But so they were rebuilt from 044 tank engines to 060 big-ass engines that were used during the war. It makes sense.
Oh, this is bizarre.
Oh, no. Oh, Chris, go sit in the corner and think about what you
I think I understand what's going on with this now, because I'm doing it as Chris normally set, simulates it, like, you know, hold L, hold O, you tap O, you tap the injector on this one. Anyway, so Anthony's now on the train, so what is he? Is he just a passenger or what?
I'm actually the fire in the firebox.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Stuff some coal in his face.
That's a nice firebox animation, actually.
Yeah, do you want me to show you it off? Show it off again. If I can get to the right cab view! There you go. Oh, that is... that. It actually looks like a... I know, you can obviously tell it's an animation, but it looks pretty good. I mean, oh, we were going to look around, weren't we, while we're here? So I've just pressed 8. So, yeah, we're in the firebox now.
Why am I really tempted to pull that? You're spoiling my fire quote.
Complained Henroid. Ah, yeah, you can see it's got a 3D firebox. Mm. And then you got the fire animation there. Yeah, sorry to like be dissecting this loco and ruining it for everybody, but yum.
It's not ruining, it's a gift.
I'm exploring it.
Ages to get in there. From what I can remember Chris saying, like, that gift took way longer than they thought.
Yeah. But as you can see in here, we have got like the frames and everything in here, but it's not animated. Yeah, but then again, it is very tight in here, so I imagine that it'd be unnecessary, because look at that. Look how tight that is to get in. It must have been a nightmare oiling this thing.
Oh, Daddy, it's so tight. Wait, one.
Oh, my God, Chris, shut up.
Here's the thing, because...
Oh, this livery. I'm loving this livery. Look at it. Mmm.
Does that say Ashford Works or Ashford Works?
Ashford, you absolute banana.
I thought it was a G. Oh, no, I can see it now.
But yeah, I think the G5 has got animated valve gear.
Yeah. I mean, we're not going to go too much into it. At the end of the day, it's really, really nice to have a Southeastern and Chatham Railway logo in-game. It helps me out enormously. And also, it's good for the Bluebell group that's out. So we can actually run this on the Bluebell. All we need now is an O-class and a C-class, and we've got some more Southeastern locos.
Yeah.
You know what we also need? We need a new Dilla trip.
We need to do everything.
we need
everything.
Like, yeah, that's why I'm like happy that Chris has said he's doing Southern this entire year.
This is literally my year then, because I am a Southerner. I love the Southern. Yeah. So
we needed Southern for ages, because
problem is, it means I might have to recast my entire railway.
Fuck you, no you don't.
Oh. It's just like, yeah, I don't know, Brian turns into a H-class.
God damn it, Tom.
Yeah. Well, I'm just thinking, because, what's it, for Bluebell stuff, a C-class would be good as well.
Well, I think that's probably going to be on the cards. If Chris and DT are going to be concentrating on Southern, I mean, obviously, I know Chris, he'll be doing the Victorian era stuff.
Yeah,
which obviously is nice. So it's nice to have some pre-grouping logos. I mean, obviously it'd be nice to see things like, you know, a Yuri H-class, sorry.
Yeah.
And things like that.
Or a Q-boat.
I mean, me personally, I mean, obviously I don't know what is in store. I don't know what's on the radar, and I'm not going to demand anything, because the last thing any of us want to do is demand from Chris anything, or DT anything, or anyone really. At the end of the day, they want to model what they want to model. However, if I were to ask for something or suggest something, a lot of people... I mean, the problem is there's not really anywhere authentic to run it, but I'd love to see things like the Mansell W-class tank, the 264, and the Z-class 080.
Oh, yes.
I mean, we all talk about the Z-class, don't we?
The Z-class.
Here at DDJP, we value the Z-class tank engine.
Yeah, we love the Z-class.
Let me go check it out. Oh, my fucking God.
I love the well tanks on it.
You know what?
Tiny ass tanks, though. It looks like they cannibalized the J50 and were like, no, mine now.
The whole point of it was that it was only for, like, hump shunting, really.
Yeah, hump shunting and banking. That was literally the whole point. They weren't designed.
Oh my God, every time someone mentioned banking, I think of work, because I'm learning how to do the bankings at work.
So you're every time. What Brian is now.
Yeah, basically, yeah. I'm doing what Brian does. I'm working on the I mean, for me at work, my finances is I've got to count the ATM safe, I've got to count the float safe, and I've got to count the top safe. And then I've got to organise all the money, move it all around, and then put it back where it came from, essentially.
Yeah.
So it's a scary thing to have to do, especially with someone like me with autism and whatnot. But hey ho, apparently I'm good at it, so good.
Hey. I'm just thinking that if
God,
we are
I'm really sorry,
suggest...
I'm very, very quickly, that lean is incredibly noticeable from this angle.
Yeah, it is a bit. It's like the brakes are on.
I wonder if that's No, it wasn't the handbrake. Or was it? I don't know, hold on.
Ooh, a penny.
Oh God dear. God damn it, Anthony.
There's a penny stuck on my fucking what's it called? Buffer beam. Shit, help.
Yeah, I'm just thinking, like, if we're gonna like other southern engines that I would like to see. I know it's not everybody's cup of tea. It's not everybody's cup of pee, but
my God, the frames are tanking. Carry on.
Yeah, a Yuri G16.
Oh, is that what I think it is?
The 480 tank engine.
Oh, wrong engine. I was thinking of the T14. The Drummond T14.
T14 would be nice as well.
I mean, again, it depends really on the modeler, it depends on getting drawings for it. It's just the fact that I know that we're getting southern stuff to kids, making my mind whirl around what we're going to get, what sort of locos are in the pipeline. The Year of Southern from Digital Traction, which is where they started, really, because they're going back to it, if you've noticed. Because originally DT made, like, the light rebuilt Light Pacific, the original Light Pacifics, the M7, Bully Coaches, all that lot. Mortal Coaches, yeah. And then we sort of went to my mixed bag of things like LNER and, I don't think... Oh, did they do LMS?
No.
Yeah, they did.
What did they do?
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, that's right. Where did I say? Oh, we're going to go to Axley, so I'm going to go this way. Because I should be able to run around in that platform.
By the way.
Hello.
Just to get everyone to pop that blue pill.
Yeah.
T9 and Southern Malachite.
Oh. Actually, I think a T9 is probably going to be on the cards. Because we've got a Drummond M7, so a T9. Also, more advantageous, if the T9 is actually running at Swanage at the moment, so...
Yeah,
you know, if DT want me to come down and say hi, I'd like to live there. Oh, switched into the wrong platform again.
Hey, guys.
What?
H-Class is now available.
Oh.
Is it? Where? Like, I've been having a look around. I don't see any links to, like, DT or Chris.
We'll go and look on the website,
then. It's on the website.
I'm looking.
We supply products directly to Steam
platform.
The Steam platform?
Mind.
What are you on about? Is it out or not?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, well, I'll have to edit the description and put the link in. So, yeah, anyway, H-Class is out now. So this is really trying. If you like it, go and buy it. Buy it, buy it, buy it. Off you go. Someone get a link in the live stream chat. Go and buy.
Yeah, it's early access. We got early access to it
for like 5 minutes.
For an hour?
I kind of forgot that this was under DT's list rather than Chris's. So I was looking in there.
You did look.
I think it's because obviously Chris is the one who's been working on this.
Yeah, so we automatically associate with Chris because, you know, we like to drink with Chris because Chris is our mate. And when we drink with Chris, we like to, I wonder what the next word could have been.
Masturbate. Wait, what?
Oh, no! So, yeah, if someone had got the link, I will edit the description later on.
I've got the link.
Oh man, I'm sorry. That was just amazing. I don't remember the last one, masturbate.
I've got the linky do. I'll send you it as a private.
All right, cool beans. Well, no, I meant put it on the live stream chat.
Oh, in the live stream chat. Okay.
Yeah, get people to, you know, we're supporting DT and Caledonia Works and all that. So go bye.
What's the signer's name?
Harry Wainwright.
Harry Wainwright.
Uh huh.
Why was that so hard?
Because I've got a speech impediment, leave me alone.
Shit, I feel like an asshole.
you freaking cheesehead.
As you can see, right, I'm the master of advertising. Buy it now!
I'm glad I decided to do this now.
No!
Who mentioned that it was out then?
Em and Luke.
Oh, Luke. Right, cheers, Luke. And Pleb. Oh, and Em. Oh, well, no one likes him. Nobody liked him, but
he's
anyway,
like a bat.
I'm still going to point out though that this loco does look very at home on the DR.
It does, yeah.
Even now, just doing its run round.
Mm, it's gorgeous.
So yeah, now if people want it, go get it, because I would fully recommend it already. I'm sure that there's some things that may or may not need editing, like that lean, but again, it's only minor stuff. As regards to the rest of the loco, it's definitely worth it. How much is it retailing for anyway, just out of curiosity?
$14.99.
How much?
$14.99.
Ah, that's not too bad. You get 8 liveries with it, to be fair.
Mm-hmm. And locomotion
1.2.
Oh, apparently, right, mm-hmm. The fire glow syncs with the chuffs.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, yeah, that's true. That does happen. That is a thing.
That is a thing that does happen from time to time.
That is a thing that occurs if I go and... I love how the camera just literally throws me around everywhere. So if I... It was the same in the N7 anyway, so it doesn't... So, there you go, you can see it.
But Tom, I'm blind.
Oh, that was splendid. So yeah, I was already aware of that, it's just that I'd already mentioned it in the N7 video. But that's basically now... For DT and Caledonia Works, the Locomotion 1.2 for the time being is going to be what you'd call industry standard, if you like. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Mm. Only, I mean, I don't know whether Guillaume's working on a 1.3 or any other whatevers, but as far as I'm aware, 1.2 is going to be the standard for future DT and Caledonia Works products from the time being. And I would definitely recommend trying it out, because mainly for Sim Nations 1.2, because I didn't understand it until I saw it implemented on a locomotive. And now I've seen it implemented, I now understand what Guillaume was talking about and how it's scripted. So, yeah. Very, a lot to like about this loco. And a lot to like about the scripting. Oh, I did see somewhere that somebody complained about the smoke particle effect somewhere. I think it's on UK Train Sim. I don't know. Because I don't mind them, actually, to be fair. And also, there is a way of editing them anyway. If people are dissatisfied with how thick they are, there is a way to edit them, but you need to know how to do bin file editing. Because you basically need to turn down the amount of particles it emits. Basically what I did to Eustace and 257 in the old days.
Oh, fair enough.
Thick with two C's.
Guys.
Hello.
I'm like, I'm going to go buy the H-Class. Let me just check my bank details first.
Oh.
£3. Oh, shit.
I would literally lend you the money, Chris, but...
Nah, Big Bob.
Also, I'm kind of saving money for other things at the moment. Like, not only that, I've got my holiday coming up, and I've got to think about moving, and I've got to think about masturbating, and I've got to think... Well, actually, no, I've done that already today, so it's fine.
Oh, shit.
I'm not actually joking. I literally had to.
Dini, fash yourself, Tom. Don't
worry, would you like to know why, Chris?
No.
Well, you know I've mentioned my little problem downstairs.
No.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
I know.
Basically, I'm just saying, it's really annoying because I had to do that, and then I had to do urine test, and then I have to take that to the doctors, and it's just like, thanks, I hope that this gives me some sort of result. I'm not going to go much into detail.
You can't give just the age class, apologies for this, rather.
Yeah, we're really sorry about me essentially talking about my, you know, people come for DDJP and well, because, you know, we're awesome, but...
You're an idiot, that's why.
Oh, wow, rude.
Hold on a second, look at the back.
Yeah. Ooh. What about
that
it?
That back buffer beam.
Oh yeah, there's no number.
Oh!
Rude! Can we stop nitpicking, please? I'm literally sat here really enjoying this engine, and here's Anthony looking at it and going, oh, I wonder, there's something else wrong. Oh, there's something else.
I'm going to do the, oh, it's all wrong.
Oh, so Anthony is our rivet counter for the day. And this, you
see, joking.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is why Anthony doesn't get any early access. That was a bit harsh, sorry.
This is why Anthony has no friends.
Wait, what are we then?
Imagination.
Can somebody explain what the circle with the cross on it is for, by the way? I don't know I don't know whether somebody in the chat can tell us what it means.
No, I know what it is.
What is it then?
It's a disc.
Really, Chris?
I thought you really? Were about to say it's a circle with a cross in it.
It's a religious symbol.
I was, but then I was like, no, that's too obvious.
You're Belen, Chris, and no one likes you.
Soldier returns from 3 years, 3 year mission to finally meet his 2-month-old baby. Wait, what?
I'm doing a bit of Googling.
Callum is our Googler while he's sat on the train.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be the guard.
He's supposed to be the guard, but he's actually just on the train, like, you know, Googling stuff about this engine.
Because
this is a special visitor from the Bluebell Railway, seeing as Brian went there, we borrowed one of their engines.
SE and CR steam locomotive head coach. That's what they're looking at. Oh, where? Load up website.
Ooh.
Okay, so it's basically. I would hazard a guess. It's a destination code. Yeah, it's just a destination code.
So that's the idea.
Basically, you change those discs depending on where you go, and basically allows you more destinations, basically.
So essentially, because I know that the whole point of the codes is for the signalman, like, to say where the locomotive is going, like, that's why it must be quite difficult being a signaller on the Southern, because it's not like other regions, which is just like, you know, two lamps are an express and all that. It's like, literally, here's like 15 discs that you need to remember what they're for.
Yeah, so, put up a head code, and I'll tell you what it means.
Okay, right, there you go, you'll see it in a sec. It's basically a crossed disc on the top, and a normal white disc on the right-hand buffer beam, as you look at it.
On the right, as you look at it,
okay. If you look at the image, you'll see what I mean.
Yeah, I can see it. That is Victoria and Ramsgate Harbour Branch via Catford Loop.
Okay, that's not what we're running. Give us a head code then, Cat. Give us a head code appropriate for where I might be. Because I'm going to turn these 72. Off for a minute. Shut up, Chris.
If you put a cross at the top and a cross on the right, that's just via North Kent.
Well, we're in South Kent.
Oh, fuck's sake.
But I can't be held accountable for this.
Chris, you're an absolute Kent, you know that.
I am what I lick.
They're all different. Yeah, they're all for different lines, so.
Well, I want one for like, like around Ashford or, I'm trying to think where. I mean, where have you said the DR set?
Okay, so Ashford.
Uh-huh.
Ashford and Hastings, right? You ready
for this?
That's
correct. Yep, go on.
Single white disc on the right, as you look at it.
So what I've got now?
Oh, let me just see whether it catches up. So, yeah, there you go.
So that's to Ashford?
Yeah, that's Ashford and Hastings.
Okay, that suits me just fine. I'm gonna have to invent my own for the DR. Mm. Like, one single headlamp means, holy shit, here comes a train. Go on.
Sorry. According to this, right, a disc and a lamp in the centre lower, so in the middle of the engine, that's a day special.
Hang on, when we stop, we'll have a look at that.
So if you put a lamp in the middle between the buffers, then that counts as a special.
Oh, no, you stupid bloody signalman.
Is he sending you in towards the works?
Oh, no, I hope not. Wait, no, wait. Hold on. I think we might actually be okay. Yes!
It came in at 500 miles an hour.
Yeah, well, it sent us to where I wanted to go, back into the bay platform.
Yeah, he's sending you to Ashford. You shouldn't have put that code up, Tom.
Oh, no. Yeah, that's a fair point, actually. It'd be cool if the game did recognise that, wouldn't it?
Mm. Yeah.
I've just noticed that Mr. Chairman Bench is still at Gallon Junction as well.
Oh, for fuck's sake. We can't move that thing, Tom. He'll kill us.
I know, but we need to move it to the Soma branch at some point. So, Callum, what's the head code again, sorry? I'm going to take the disc off and try it again. So,
okay. No. If you keep the disc on, yeah, and just put a lamp in the middle.
Above or lower or upper?
Lower.
Right, a lamp.
Yeah, a lamp in the middle, yep, on the lower, with the disc, right? That is a special.
Okay, that'll do. Oh, I just noticed something. I know not many people really care, but I've just noticed something really interesting about the lamp. Mm-hmm. When you look at it, it's actually, instead of it just being a bright light, you can actually see that it's got like a, you know, an oil lamp inside it.
Yeah.
Like an oil wick. That's freaking awesome. Because that's what they actually were. That is literally all a lamp was. Sometimes we're at Gallon Junction. Yeah. And Gallon's the thing is to be had here at Gallon Junction.
Because the thing is that those lamps are not really meant to show the way, are they?
How can I explain? They're not like, you know, like a high intensity light. They're not like that. They were literally, yeah, the reason they have a light at all is at night, the signalman from a distance would be able to see the, yeah, like the head code. So for example, at night, if we were running at night, it'd be a bit more difficult because the disc wouldn't be in use, because obviously the discs don't matter at night. So
yeah, but yeah, the thing is that
I like how we're teaching people stuff while we do this, you know.
Yeah, we're being very educational.
Educational, yeah. I like that. Anyway,
I'm disappointed in myself.
Good. Why? We're disappointed with you too.
I have so many bad puns in my head right now.
Like what?
Like, for example, how the discs weren't used at night. I guess you could say they were discontinued.
Well, we are discovering stuff today, aren't we, Chris?
I guess you could say you guys are disgusted with my puns.
I am actually very disappointed with you.
That was bad.
That was terrible, I know. Anyway, I hope people are enjoying this Dark Tries anyway, because we're going to go back to Cole Happer and leave it there. Because now that it's out, I want to edit the description to put a link to it there. I would recommend it, definitely, especially if you're like me and you love, like, you know, southern region stuff, or would you want more appropriate stuff for the southern. So, yeah, I definitely recommend this locomotive.
Or if you just want to support the content creators so they can get more of the products that we all love.
Absolutely. I mean, the way that DT and Caledonia works are basically, you know, churning stuff out at the moment. Yeah, it's very quick, but it's also high quality. It's not like with some, there's two different flip-flops, you could say, because there are certain developers who take ages and ages and ages to develop something, and it either comes out really good or really rubbish, like in some cases I know of. Or in some cases, just like, you know, people announce the project and then it never materializes at all, haha. Because it just keeps getting cancelled because they can't bother to finish it. Anyway, and there are other developers who just, like, whack stuff out and it's all, like, you know, rubbish. Which I can't even think of an actual, like, oh no, I can think of a certain developer I'm not going to mention, because we're not allowed to mention that person on YouTube anymore, apparently. I'll tell you guys who I mean later on. I think people can guess, but let me just put it this way. The locos they made include the old 9F, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
But with DT, well, in particular Chris, because he works to a very high standard anyway, and he works very hard on his stuff, and this is his literal day job, you can really tell the quality where he does it. So, and also with DT, just the fact that they're, you know, actually they seem to care quite a lot about what they're doing at the moment, and they're quite active in promotion. So
basically, they're thinking about the speed it's coming out without sacrificing the quality of the product.
Yeah, I mean, look at this. I mean, this is going to be a great shot here underneath the main road between Bath Gallon Junction.
As soon as you get out of the fucking bush, there you go. Yeah, it is out now, Jack Sheriff.
Go buy it.
Yeah, no, go buy it.
Please consider purchasing the product, Callum. Go buy it.
Yeah. I mean, look at this shot, though. I mean, the other thing I'd recommend as well, guys, go and get these South Eastern Chatham Railway birdcages, because they really suit it.
They do look nice.
I have the Southern Green version.
Yeah, well, that's fine. You just don't be able to drive the Southern livery then.
But looking at these ones, you want really them now.
Yeah.
Wait, hang on. Isn't there a sale going on?
There might be. There you go, everyone. There's a March Madness sale going on at the moment, so go get it.
Go buy it!
Said Callum.
It's literally £1.50.
Go and get it then. Wait, I didn't know you could get £0.50.
Yeah, 50p.
Yeah, but I've never heard someone refer to it as £0.50.
I'm retarded, okay?
Yeah, we know that.
Oh. Wow.
I mean, like, I don't know whether people wanted to know anything about the history of this these locomotives, but, I mean, I can give you a very detailed history of them ready. They go chuff. The end.
Oh my god, Tom, that I just did not know that.
No, but in all seriousness, these things were quite handy little locos because they were fitted with push-pull equipment in later years. Yeah, so they could run. They ran what were called motor trains, which are basically auto trains for the Southern.
Yeah. I can give a history. I've got the source of all the local loco files information on here.
Oh right, so you're helping Mr. Wright, are you?
Yes, I am. Thank
you. Oh, excellent.
Just as access to Wikipedia.
Okay, so you're ruining the magic.
In it.
Right, the South Eastern Chatham Railway H-Class is a class...
Oh, my God!
It's a class of 044 steam locomotive.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
I did not notice that when I was driving at Callum.
No, I did not notice that either.
No one did.
Originally designed for suburban passenger work, designed by Harry Wainwright in 1904.
Oh, most my God, he said it right.
Most of
right.
The six...
Ah.
I know, that's...
I literally can't say it right, so...
Most of the 66 members of the class were later equipped for push-pull working for use on rural branch line.
Can I give you something to push-pull?
Cheeky. Anyway.
And also, the H-class boiler design was found to be so successful, it was later used as standard replacement boiler on the R1, the LCDR, B1.
London Chatham and Dover Railway.
Yeah, London Chatham. Dover B2 and R class, Southeastern O1, Southeastern Q1, and Southeastern R1. All 66 locomotives were equipped with vacuum brakes as used on the former Southeastern Railway.
They were all murdered.
The 13 also had Westinghouse air brakes and were used on the former London Chatham Dover lines.
Yeah, I think all of these have the air brakes on them as standard, though, like the model anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good picture. Look at that.
Leicester. Wait, what?
Also, we've got some incidents. We've got one accident.
Oh.
Was that Chris?
Shit.
Yeah, he's the biggest accident here. And to clarify,
we're on about Matheson, not Wilson.
Yeah, because
yeah,
Mr. Wilson.
You guys.
Mr. Wilson, and he's the opposite of an accident. He is.
He has a mustache, therefore he is.
Bay.
I shaved the other day. That's the only reason I don't have a mustache. Anyways, accidents. Not
accidents,
me.
Accidents, accidents, accidents,
accidents. Accidents. On 11th of March, 1913, locomotive number 324...
Shut up.
Locomotive number 324 was hauling a passenger train that failed to stop at Ramsgate Town Station in Kent. It collided with a van and pushed it through the buffers.
Cheeky.
Ten people were injured. The accident was caused by the failure to connect the brake pipe between the locomotive and its train.
That isn't funny, but it is at the same time.
Mm. And the class were withdrawn between 1944 and 1964.
Oh shit, they survived a long time.
Yeah, they were handy for... That's what I mean about the motor trains and why M7 lasted so long as well. Mm. Because they were small but fast, they were very good at motor train running, which is basically push-pull running. Because they could be operated on branch lines, and more importantly, they weren't as heavy as the standard locomotives. That's why they were retained for those sort of duties, I believe.
Fair enough. Get me, Callum!
I've got more information here. Two members of the class were withdrawn during the Second World War, but the remaining 64 entered British Railway stock in 1948. 45 of the survivors were equipped for push-pull train working between 1949 and 1960. And the class was increasingly used on motor trains, as you say, on rural branches, with completion of the Kent electrification scheme between 1959 and 1962.
Which I will point out, they conveniently skipped us.
Yeah. Most of the surviving members of the class were withdrawn, except for a few examples.
Which were eaten.
They were eaten on the non-electrified lines between Tunbridge Wells and Three Bridges.
I like how Tom is, like...
I tried to alt-tab and it didn't work.
No, how you didn't even acknowledge the fact that they got electrified.
Well, yeah. I mean, like, they literally electrified the railway line past Horton. But then when it came to electrifying to Cole Hapren onwards to Gannon Junction, they're like, you know what, nah. And the DR just literally, like, here, like, what the fuck, man? Like, literally, we are a railway line. And they're just like, yeah, but you're a shit railway line. And they don't appreciate us.
We're not going to electrify you.
It's electrifying.
Well, it's electrifying. Oh, by the way, Callum and Anthony.
Okay. Oh, what?
Looking at NSFW?
No.
NSFW?
Not suitable for plebs, it should be.
Mm.
So that was a run with the H-Class. I hope people liked it, and I hope people go and get it, basically. Because it's worth eating for lunch.
What the fuck?
I don't know. I don't understand what's wrong with my head. But in all honesty, like, I think it's nice that we've actually got a Southeastern tank engine now. I mean, if we get a C-Class as well... Like, having a Southeastern 060 tender engine as well will look very good with this. Especially on a double header on the Bluebell Railway or something.
Oh, fucking, by the way.
No.
That one accident happened in Kent. You're in Kent right now.
I wonder why that could be. I wonder who caused that accident. It was probably Fear and Otter distracting it when they went off on their adventures on the main line. Because they did that, you know. They literally buggered off onto the main line and they're just like, oh, we're going to go to Noisham People now. Anyway, we're going to end it here, but we're going to move. I'm going to have the. We're going to head off down to Wuncong Upper West. Oh, but before we do, actually, I'm going to go over and show Anthony the other liveries that come with it because I know he's a pleb.
Oh, he can rewatch the video, the fucking asshole.
Well, he could, but I mean, is Anthony still here?
No.
Okay. Well, I'm going to show him anyway. So, what livery particularly do you want to look at, Anthony? Because there's loads.
Let's just have a peek about.
Okay, so we'll start over here again. So, just to recap for everyone who missed the beginning of the video, First World War, wartimes, Southeastern Chatham Railway grey, Southern Railway olive, yummy, and then you got Southern black, which makes it look like 53 when it was running like this at Swanage, British Railways with bullied malachite sunshine lettering, and then you got the 3BR livery, so you got early British Railways, which I will point out, nice touch. The early British Railways one doesn't have a head code or any a shed plate or anything at the front.
Ah.
Whereas the other two do. So yeah, that's quite a touch. Because that's literally transitional.
Yeah, because they would have been rushed through the paint shop, wouldn't they?
Yeah. Also, have noted that DT have indeed modelled every single one of the variants with air pumps.
Ah.
So that's interesting. Right. So, oh, hang on. Hello. Ooh. Uh-oh. Ooh. I don't know if you guys look at that building plate. They've just mirrored it on this side. Oh, dear.
Oh.
Right. Do you know what? I'm going to run away before we make any more criticisms and upset people. God damn it.
You made that one. Don't blame us.
I know. Ah, and I think I might have overfilled my boiler. So anyway, apology for that.
Retard.
Yeah. Well, if people at DT are watching, you're welcome, I guess. I'm helping point out things. Might be thinking a patch. I'll talk to Chris about it. And Chris will pass it on to DT, who will probably look into things like that. Again, this is why I would be a good beta tester, because I actually use my... What are they called, guys? Eyeballs?
No, but you have four pairs of eyes, Tom. You have your
eyes. Oh, yeah, I've got my glasses as well. Yeah, that's true. That's not a criticism to anybody who works on these models, by the way. It's just that sometimes it's good to have a fresh pair of eyes on something. Mm-hmm. You know? It's like me when I do the root building. Sometimes that's why I like it when I root building and I've got the live stream running. Because sometimes it's good to have a fresh pair of eyes to say, oh, this looks, you know, X, this looks Y.
Or when you're coming up with story ideas.
And you lot sit here and go, what a stupid idea, Chom. Anyway, Callum, would you like to blow the gas whistle? Just say meet meep or something. Oh, hang on, wait a sec. Hang on, everyone shush. Oh, there is actually a right of way. It's UK. Oh. Not UK, UK. So, anyway. It doesn't sound like Callum, so Callum, just say right away.
Right away.
Let's go. So,
be gone, thought.
So, that was the Southeastern Chatham Railway H-Class. So, if you liked it, go and buy it. If you didn't like it, still go and buy it because it's a good engine.
Yeah, go buy it!
Just go buy it, as Callum said.
Yeah, I'm head of advertising.
Callum is head of advertising. Also, I'm going to put up a post in the Facebook page regarding Patreon. Obviously, there is a link to the Patreon campaign down here. But if people like that idea, please leave a comment about the possibility of opening the Patreon campaign to things like, you know, driver experience courses on the DR. So, yeah, we're going to leave it there. I'm going to mute everything. So, thanks everybody for watching, and we will see you next time. Thank you very much. See you later.
Go buy it.